When we take a look at the pedal box, we can see that we have three pedals, unlike the two that are common with automatic transmissions. So, if you look on the far left, we have the clutch pedal, we have the brake pedal, and we have the gas pedal. Sorry about that. Now, when we look at the gearbox, we have everything in a numerical succession. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's run through the gears. I press the clutch all the way in, and I look, and I place it right in the middle. And if I look over here back, I release my foot, and it's in neutral. So this area that it moves is the neutral position. All these areas are neutral. So I'm gonna press the clutch pedal in once again, and I'm gonna show you how I go from first gear, second gear, third gear, fourth gear. I push it to the side, fifth gear, and sixth gear. Now, every time I push the gear lever to the left, it comes back to the centering ring. To the right, it comes back to the centering ring. Now, the centering ring, it's important to note, is between 3 and 4. So then, if I want to engage the reverse mechanism, I'm going to move it to the left, and I'm going to push it because there's a little resistance, and then I push it up. That is designed for you not to engage the reverse mechanism whenever you're going forward in traffic. So you can imagine going 50 miles an hour, you're decelerating to 30, to 20, to 10, and you want to get into second gear or first gear. You don't want to ever engage the reverse because that'll just cause permanent damage to your gearbox, and it'll be a mechanic's nightmare. So now that my clutch pedal is still in, it goes back to the centering ring that we've spoke about, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now once you get used to the gearbox, it becomes second nature, and it's something that you rarely ever think about. So this is a pretty short video on how to engage the reverse mechanism. In some vehicles, like a 240D Mercedes that I drove for a while back, maybe about 5 years ago, maybe 10 years ago, I don't even remember when, but I remember that one, you had to actually push or lift the actual gear lever and then engage it to the side because that was like a locking out mechanism. So every car is different. You just have to read the owner's manual in order to understand better how to engage the reverse mechanism. In this case, the reverse mechanism is, you just have a resistance on the far left, according to the H pattern that you have over here. You lock it in place and you push up. And then, in order to really make the vehicle move slowly, you lift slowly, and the car will automatically move by itself. And if you need to go faster, you give it a little bit of gas, but it has to be a balancing act. So thank you for watching this video on how to engage the reverse mechanism on a Porsche Cayenne. If you would please consider liking this video and subscribing and even leaving comments, because this entire video was inspired by a person who left a comment down below who really wanted to understand how the reverse mechanism is engaged in this car. So if you have any other suggestions about future videos, please like, please subscribe, and comment down below. Thank you for watching.